Why my intro?
I don't know, because this video is starring you. Yeah, this is a video about you suffering. On the plus side, the next time we do any truth or dares games or any game in which there's a punishment if you don't do what you're supposed to do, I know exactly what I need to put you through. Anything that involves God's Not Dead or Christian movies.
Well, hello, everybody.
Welcome to hell.
I'm Sleepy Slayer.
I'm Satan, and I am here. SCP Slayer unfortunately died in a Minecraft accident, and I am now Satan delivering him his hell for all eternity. Okay, so fun fact here about SCP. Well, I guess if you haven't heard from this little long intro, he's an atheist. I am a Christian.
Yes.
And I've seen the first movie of God's Not Dead. I have my opinions on it. I'm not going to say anything until later on because I do have a plan that I'm hoping to accomplish. I'm pretty sure he already knows. But we thought it would be interesting if an atheist and a Christian watched the trailers to the God's Not Dead movies. Because God's Not Dead is quite popular in the Christian industry, I guess. I don't know. This is a movie that's
no
popular.
Idea why it has so many.
Yeah, this movie, like a lot of churches I went to talked about this movie or played this movie.
I like the image there on the side. It's just like Christian movies are not good.
Oh, don't look at this. Don't look.
It's just funny.
So, I'm gonna have to cut off a lot of this intro, by the way. Either way, though, as you can see here, I didn't mean to do that. It has quite a decent good ratings. I'm very surprised by
Why
this.
Does everyone always wind up highlighting their things when they go to do that?
I don't know. I'm just very surprised that it has a decently good amount of likes based on a lot of videos I've seen that criticize this movie harshly. Either way, you ready? Let's just get onto it.
Time for pain and suffering.
Whole thing. Let's just get...
You prayed and believed your whole life. And here you are. Explain that to me.
What do you say to people that are offended by your show? Because you pray to Jesus in every episode.
If we disown him, he'll disown us.
Wait, is that isn't he in Duck Dynasty? I just realized that. Isn't he from Duck Dynasty?
That's straight up Duck Dynasty right there. That's what they do at the end of every episode.
Oh, so they're actually talking about his show. I don't watch Duck Dynasty. I've never watched Duck Dynasty.
Yeah. I have the first season, and my brother has the rest, so it's just like...
Oh, so they're actually... Yeah. I feel stupid. So they're actually talking about the actual show.
They're talking about the actual show, yeah.
Oh.
That's actually him in his actual...
I feel so stupid because I've seen this movie, but I never realized, I didn't realize that he was from Duck Dynasty. I don't watch the show, guys. I don't watch Duck Dynasty. I don't.
It's been a while since I watched Duck Dynasty. I forget his name. Is that Willy? I think it's Willy.
I do have a question. Do they actually pray at the end of every episode?
Yeah, at the end of every episode. They have dinner and pray.
For the record, he's the only one that went in this movie, so I wonder what the others think.
I'm imagining Ty getting over.
12-year-old watches his mother dying of cancer. A god who would allow that is not worth believing in. Life is really a tale told by an idiot.
My mother died of cancer, motherfucker, and I still believe in God. Just pointing that out there.
Full of sound and fury and signifying nothing.
Name? Wheaton. Josh Wheaton. Philosophy 150. You might want to think about a different instructor.
Come on, man. It can't be that bad.
Think Roman Colosseum. People cheering for your death.
I am Professor Radisson. This is Philosophy 150. I would like to bypass senseless debate altogether and jump to the conclusion, which every sophomore is already aware of, there is no God. All that I require from each of you is that you fill in the papers I've just given you with three
little words, God is dead.
Can I?
Okay, what?
Can I point out, any good atheist is not that dickish. This guy is not a proper atheist. He is a dumbass.
I actually did have a English teacher that was like him, though. I'm not trying to, like, say this movie is right, but I did have a teacher that was like that. As in, he was very, very against Christians. Oh, well, Christianity. I wouldn't say Christians, but Christianity, because his teacher helper, who is in classes to become a full-time English teacher, is a very devoted Christian. And you could tell there was always this tension between the two because he hated Christianity that much. Do you ever, you know, the story, it was like during the shoot, there was like a shooting and then the gunner was like, do you believe in God? And she said yes, and then he killed her because of that. And that's like a very big story that Christians talk about. Because, you know, it's been written in books and all that. He actually, I kid you not, he actually stood up and said that that story was not true. He said that that never happened.
What?
Yeah, he flat out said that that never happened. That that was just a propaganda that Christians use. I would say about a month later, he did get fired. Not because of Christian, anything like this professor did. Because, you know, the guy never did anything like this to Christians. But he was really like... Okay, he wasn't afraid to say he hated Christianity, but he never let that affect, like, he never told Christians that they couldn't be Christians. Nothing like that. He ended up getting fired because, the principal never really liked him to begin with, and he ended up throwing a pencil sharpener at a student. That's why he got fired. Nothing about religion, but he was a bad... He was this professor. This professor reminded me of that English teacher. So I'm not gonna lie, I did have a atheist English teacher like that.
I'm just gonna preface, most atheists are fine as with you as if you're Christian, just don't like start spearing or trying to convert us, because that just pisses us off a little bit.
Yeah, and I know you're probably thinking of this. No, that teacher helper never preached. He just said he believed in God and why he believed in God, but he never preached. He never mixed Christianity with his teachings at all.
Yeah, because that...
And in all fairness, neither did my English teacher. He never, like, let it affect him, like, in this way that this atheist teacher is doing. But he did, however, announce that he pretty much hated Christianity.
Mr. Wheaton, is something wrong?
I can't do what you want. I'm a Christian.
If you cannot bring yourself to admit that God is dead, then you will need to defend the antithesis.
Think of Jesus as my friend.
You think Jesus is God?
I don't want to disappoint him.
So your acceptance of this challenge may be the only meaningful exposure to God and Jesus they'll ever have.
See, to me, he's not dead. I don't want anyone to get talked out of believing in him just because this professor thinks they should.
Mr. Wheaton, are you ready?
Okay, quickly say that, like, I like how he's like saying that he doesn't want Christians to not believe in him anymore because of an atheist teacher. Literally, I just ranted about
one person.
Yeah, I mean, that has happened before, as I've witnessed it myself. But I'm just gonna be honest, as someone who literally just talked about my atheist English teacher, that is very rare and few in between. I can just tell you one thing. You can tell the difference between an atheist and just an asshole atheist, I will say. And I will tell you, it takes for a hardcore Christian, if you are so dedicated, and this is my Christian side talking. If you are 100% dedicated to God as a Christian, to your faith, you're not going to be swayed because one person hates him.
True.
We're going to put God on trial.
If you think you're smarter than me, do not try to humiliate me in front of my students. In that classroom, there is a God. I'm him.
This experiment is over. You get to decide who the most important person in your life is. Me, Professor Radisson.
But I have to do this thing. Like it's something that God wants me to do. I can't
just
turn away.
That entire sentence right there is just like, you're gonna pick a debate with a teacher over your, what I'm assuming is his girlfriend.
Oh yeah, that's his girlfriend right there. Yeah, that's his girlfriend.
You just want to ensnare them in your primitive superstition.
What I want is for them to make their own choice. That's what God wants.
You have no idea how much I'm going to enjoy failing you.
Yeah, but who are you really looking to fail? Me or God?
Oh!
God's not dead, he's surely alive.
I don't know if I'll actually be able to play this because of copyrights, but if YouTube doesn't complain, I'm gonna love this. I can't hate this song. I fucking love this song.
Why do you hate God?
God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, rolling like a lion.
Okay, that's it. So, how was it? Was it a life changing? Do you want to see this? You know, do you want to?
No, I do not want to see this. In fact, I want to keep this movie as far away from me as physically possible because it gives me a brain aneurysm.
You ready for part two? Okay. Final thoughts on this. Like, and I'm not talking about hatred or just saying it's bad. I mean, actual thoughts on this trailer. Like, what does this trailer actually tell you?
It tells me this is a very preachy movie.
It is a very preachy movie.
That's what I'm getting from this entire trailer. It's very preachy on both sides, too. It's not just, like, preachy on the, oh, God is great side. It's just, like, it's preachy on the atheist side, too. It's just, like, negative preachy on the atheist side. It's just, like, they didn't get an actual atheist. They got someone who just hates God.
It definitely is a us versus them kind of feel.
Yeah, it's more of a, hey, let's make atheists as shitty as possible so that people won't like them.
For me, like... I don't know, well, for me, what I find it interesting, they literally found, like, in this trailer, they're depicting, like, the perfect Christian versus the most hated atheist, and that's definitely far few in between.
Yes.
Not to mention that, you know, he could, as soon as the guy threatened to fail him, he could have just went to the school board and gotten the teacher fired. So, part two!
Time for pain and suffering.